The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Robert in New Jersey. Hey, Robert, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. A great show.
Thank you so much.
For years. Got a great thing. I've been listening to you for over a decade. That's amazing. You've done a great job.
I appreciate it, man. Appreciate you growling and prowling out here with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. The start to a better life or a better world or a better future is simply your belief that it is possible. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Market-wise, let's take a look at this, baby. We get the Dow Industrials down 19, NASDAQ off 22, S&P's down 9.5. Gold contract up 80 cents, traded 1,165 an ounce. Silver up a penny at $15.88 an ounce. Platinum down 8 at $9.88 an ounce. Copper down 3 pennies at $2.38 a pound. Light sweet crude off 35 cents, trading at $46.76 a barrel. Bonds, 10-year. Up 3 ticks, 128.28. 30 up 4 at 157.30. Bonds continue to reject lower price, want higher price, lower yield. King dollar. King dollar up 50 ticks right now, 94.82. King dollar's making its way down to the swing low of the bar that it's in right now, which is the August 24th bar. That swing low is 92.20, 92.50. Euro. Euro is up 20 right now at $1.13. They get the end trading at 119.80. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wonder what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? We go up to the SPY. What you're going to see, this is a classic, folks. This is a beauty, too, man. This is pretty intense. And what it is this. So picture. You're coming into the downdraft that was created out here August 20th. August 20th. Start of the downdraft, we went from 208 to 203. Following 21st, we go from 203 to 197. Next day, we go to 182. Bottom line, you're coming down with 346 million shares. What do? We do a nice counter trend bounce. We come off that low of 182.40. That was on the 24th. Climb all the way up to 202.14. That was the high that was 202.89, rather. That was the high that was generated on September 17th. That high had volume of 276 million. Now, last 4 days, we've been trying to bust into that high. Each and every day, folks, you not only have a failure, the contraction on volume is amazing. The contraction today, however, is really amazing because what you have is this. When you take a look at last Friday, Thursday, you had juice. Now, if you have the out of time in the trade, you know that it's the swing points where the market talks, walks, and squawks. We had an expansion of volume on Thursday. It was pretty neat, actually. We went from 198 to 201. We did 153 million shares. Now, that expansion was an expansion of the last few days. However, it wasn't nearly enough as to what you're going into. And what happens here is this. Picture this just like a race, that we are running a race. If the burst comes out before the swing, what happens? Boom, can't make it to the finish line. And that's exactly what we have with the volume characteristic, how we came in to Thursday, which is October 8th. We go to 201.52. You had to do 153 million shares. Okay, so now check it out from this point on because it's wild. Your benchmark, remember, is 276. First day, we come in with 153 million. Friday, we come in with 107 million. Bottom line, it holds the price. So, you know, contraction volume, but you can still do it. Monday, 56 million, And what is a mind blower is that today we're only going to probably do about 80 to 85 million, and you're failing on price, on volume, all of the above. Bottom line, this market wants lower price. I suspect you're going to go right back down the other side to the 186.93. Now, what's really cool is we're going to see this pretty quick. Why? Because what we have is that after the close out here, we have JP Morgan that's going to be coming out with earnings. Now, this is the first time that JP Morgan is coming out after the close in a long period of time. And they moved their earnings because they were worrying about what Wells Fargo was going to do, which is intriguing in itself. Bottom line, I don't think Wells Fargo came out. What they end up doing is just saying that they're going to buy GE assets, okay? Bottom line, they're coming out the 14th, and today's the 13th, right? So they're coming out at 0800 tomorrow morning. What do you have? Well, with JP Morgan, if we go over, just look at JP Morgan for a second, and what we did have is that earlier today, you know, right now you have the S&Ps and the NASDAQ are both basically around their week. But earlier today, the S&P was the weakest, and I suspect what this is going to be about, this is going to be about the JP Morgan numbers. They're cutting expenses big time, so their numbers probably are not that bad. The gross figure, though, probably is down from what they're looking for, the gross number. We go take a look at the NDX 100. Inside the NDX 100, what are we going to have after the close out here? You're going to have Intel, and Intel is a large weighting structure inside the NDX 100, as well as the Dow and the S&P. So that one's really going to get intriguing. The way Intel is trading right now, Intel's at 32.13. That thing can be at 29.42 in about a heartbeat. You know, that's also has been pushing into the downdraft that was out there from the 26th of June. And from the 26th of June, it's just not enough strength to get up and over that level. So we look at the NDX 100, the QQQ. This was a classic test this morning. If you were listening to the morning show, it was about as classic as you could get. So what have the Qs done? The Qs have done 20 million shares. This is also, man, just amazing. What's amazing about it, folks, is that this is a full day of trading, okay? And bottom line is that zero juice is in this market. I mean, in an extraordinary way, too. So bottom line, the Qs have hit a price point of 107.26. You are going to close under, let's see, so 106.64. Yeah, all you need to close under 106.64 and you get a failure. That's how that's set up. Gold, what do we have with the gold contract? Bottom line, gold wants higher price. Gold contract out here right now, folks, is trading at GCZ5. Gold has continued to reject lower price. Has lighter juice. Gold looks like it's a really sweet ABC up, an additional one. 1103 is your A, 68 is your B. So you're dealing with, 65 points, which would get you to the 1210 area. Gold wants that high out there of May 18th. 1234 looks to me is like the next number in this gold market. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. You'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are down 24. You get the NASDAQ off 25. S&P's down 10. We'll be right back, folks.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Right now, you got the Dow down 37, Nasdaq's off 30, S&Ps are down 12 and a half, and they're going to bang this thing coming into the close, folks. It's going to be interesting watching this whole thing shake out. So ESZ5, and you know, bottom line is that when you in the store and there's no one in the store, man, and they're distributing the product, then get out of the way, because this baby wants to go south in a big way. If we go over and we take a look at a few stocks that have gone south today, well, here, I'll give you the yin and the yang of it. Regeneron is just a mind blower, okay? Regeneron was up $20 yesterday. Now it's down $17.45 today. Allergens is off 8.40. You got, let's see, Ryder is down 6.68. Now, Ryder is another indication that what we're going to see here is that the way that the market looks to me right now, let me pull this up. The first benchmark, folks, that we had in this market was the October 2014 swing low. That October 2014 swing low, bottom line, had monster volume, wanted to be tested, we got it tested. Now, you know, we've had a few stocks go to the August 2011 high. That's your next number. Ryder out here is blowing apart a B point today, 69.55. We got 1.6 million shares that we needed. We got 4.1 million shares, okay? It's just taking this thing apart. This little baby, you pull this back, next stop is down into this August of 2011 high. I mean, it can go to the low. The bottom line is that, you know, we'll see whether the high holds it. Bottom line, that's where that baby wants to go. That's 57.54. Now, that's an enormous heads up in the context of where this market wants to go in general. You know, so we'll see how this does shake out, but that's how it's shaking out right now. If we go over to the NQs, the NDX 100, you want to see a strength versus a weakness. And what we did have in the NDX today, folks, is this. This is really wild. Inside the NDX, when I was doing the morning show, the four leaders were the biggest dead cat bounces, they weren't bouncing a lot. What I mean, those four stocks that were leading the NDX, they were the biggest dogs of the NDX. Right now, Tesla is up 494 at 220. Tesla has gone from a price point in the last 3 weeks from 271 to 211 in the lows today. So you can see pure dead cat bounce. Tesla wants to make its way into that high volume swing low from August 24th. Autodesk. Autodesk is up 83, and Autodesk just has gone from a price point of 62, hit a low of 42 a week and a half ago. You're coming up to ice. That's a normal bounce in an equity that wants to go to lower price. I think Green Mountain was next. Oh, Baidu. Okay, so Baidu is up 223. Baidu right now has gone from a price point of 220 down to 132. You're at 146. And the fourth strongest stock right now, ATVI. Oh, this is Activision. I think this is a pretty good stock, actually. Yeah, this is at highs. Okay, so this one is at highs. Bottom line, now, the weakness inside the NDX 100. You have JD.com, that's been miserable for a long period of time. That's down $1.77. Netflix, no doubt it's a high flyer, up $4.42. That's been pulling back. Alexa Pharmaceutical is toast. That's down $6 at $1.53. And Monster.com is down $5 at $1.32. If we go into the IBB, we take a look at the IBB. IBB is on the road, folks, downtown once again. Now, it failed at its high on price and volume. You're into the low bar, and the IBB, folks, is screaming that, number one, you're going to get to the low, which is 285. The real key is that you're going to break that low. We did more volume in the IBB on the 28th of September than we did on August 24th. What that sets up is at least a test. We'll see whether it blows it apart. My take, the IBB is going dramatically lower, not a huge amount lower. I mean, not a small amount lower. The April 2014 level, the high of that level is 245, the low is 207. You came off the highs with volume in the IBB. What does that say? That says that we're going to go to much lower price inside the IBB. We go over to Apple. We take a look at Apple. Apple trying to get the higher price today. Has lighter volume. And this is how the whole market has been generated today. Man, they're sellers. They're not even letting this get to where actually so-called resistance would be. And that's kind of how the market is set up out here also today, is that the operators inside the marketplace are not necessarily letting it get up to resistance. They're selling before resistance coming in. XL, let's go to the XLF, because I suspect what we're going to see out here is this. Yeah, XLF is starting to do it. It's the next. You know, when banks fall apart, folks, banks always fall apart. It seems that they always fall apart. They're the last sector to fall apart in the marketplace. The banks are now coming out with their numbers. This is telling me after the close out here, we're going to have some nice high volatility. The banking sector today, the XLF, tried to get into 2332, couldn't handle it. Volume is 61 million, and you're going into, volume is 24 million, and you're going into 61 million. That's a pure setup for much lower price, much faster price. Let's go over to the oil market. What we have with oil is this. Oil market out here trading down 39 cents. You have 408,000 contracts. And it looks that, you know, oil's going to pull back to the lower end of this consolidation. See how it handles the 43.71. I like how the XLE is setting up, you know, so we'll see whether oil can set up the same way. XLE is pulling back with light volume. The XLE had quite a run. We ran from 59.39 up to 69.67. You're at 67.40 right now. That baby set up. You get a nice pullback into this 63 to 60 area. And if we get it with light volume, that's telling me that we're going topside, folks. And that level can be just really a beautiful level, because the dollar index wants lower price. And it's into the bar. If we look at that dollar, DXZ, that bar that it's in right now, it's the longer that it stays at 95.27, the longer it stays, you know, underneath that, right now you're at 94.85, the higher probability is that you're going to go to the bottom of that bar. Now, the bottom of that bar, if you break the bottom of that bar, you're going to see the dollar at 85. And that is saying, hey, rates are not going up. And in fact, if we go over to the bond market and look at bonds, the way bonds are trading, bonds want higher price. Bonds continue to reject lower price, have juice as they move higher. The 10 years in an ABC structure on the way up with a 131 number on it. Right now, we're at 128.29. 30-year has not hit its B point yet. We'll see. Excuse me, folks. That's up 8 ticks right now. We'll see how it hits that B point. The B point on the 30-year is 161.17. You stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming right back. We got our man, Mr. Sal Gerberti. Sal is the president of T-Cream Funds, and we're talking corn, soybeans, wheat, all of the above tags. Check it out, folks. They trade in NYSE sugar under Cain, SOYBWEAT. We're going to be right back, folks.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now are down 42. You get the NASDAQ off 34. S&Ps are down 14. And we go over to the commodity market out here, folks. We get sugar off 2.5%. We go take a look at the, let's see, corns up 0.9%. We have wheat up 2.5%, beans are up 2.8%, and right now we get our man, Mr. Sal Gerberti. Sal is the president, folks, of T-Cream Funds, and if you want to get your portfolio diversified, folks, right at the NYSE, you want to trade corn, soybeans, sugarcane, wheat, or you want to put them all in one fund, you can do that. Trading corn, symbol CORN, soybeans, SOYB, Sugarcane, C-A-N-E, wheat, W-E-A-T, and combining them is the T-A-G-S. And you talk about something sweet, man. That sugar has gone to the moon. Sal, what's going on?
How you doing, Tom?
I'm doing great. Yourself?
I'm doing just fine.
You know, I'll tell you, I know that these are your commodities, but I'm telling you, I've been doing, you know, the gold report since 2001, 2002, and it's pretty wild because when we're first getting into gold, I was thinking that, you know, gold's going to go up and the rest of the market's going to go down. And then I realized that, you know, what happened is that everything went up, okay? But it's been really interesting about the last last 6 or 7 weeks, even as the market's been pulling back, metals start moving. But this is my perception now, is that we really got a commodity market that's moving because all these softs are also moving with volume now too, you know? So that's my technical view. Now, I know you can give us a fundamental view because they just come out with an agriculture report last week, right?
They did, and you know, that report, essentially, it didn't have many surprises. It did show, though, that wheat acres were a bit steady. Corn acres were down, and that was not unexpected, I think. But more importantly, I think, you know, the, on a macro level, to your point, the CRB index looks like it's trying to put in a bottom here. Sugar looks like it's trying to put in a bottom, and you've got the real strengthening against the dollar today. I think that, you know, that's probably a pretty good sign. And some people in the soybean markets today thought that that made a big difference, that the real strengthening, dollar weakening, that might take some Brazilian soybeans off the market. Soybeans, I think, were up, you know, almost 3% at one point. So you've got these markets moving, and then you've got the seasonal, where we're in peak harvest time here in the Northern Hemisphere. Corn and soybeans and wheat are all coming in hard, corn especially. You're knocking on the door of cost of production. If you look at these continuation charts, corn at 360 a bushel, wheat basically dollar higher, 460 a bushel, beans call it 860, 880 a bushel. They're really having a hard time getting through those numbers. So from a cyclical basis, we're looking probably at some potential seasonal lows here, which is being confirmed by the CRB index and the other commodities having a little bounce.
And folks, you know, as you come over to our website at TFNN, the last time Sal was on, we got a couple great charts and, you know, a white paper. It's right under breaking news, and it's the seasonal price pattern in con. Yeah, and you know, it's really wild. And what's crazy is that, you know, everyone keeps talking about the strong dollar, but yet the dollar, to me, topped out like 8 months ago. So it's going to be intriguing to see how it attacks, you know, August 24th went to a low, it went fast, furious. And I understand the fundamental concept that the dollar is stronger than everything else, but all the currencies are weak. So it's like, you know, you're eating something, it's a hard asset. It looks to me like we got some hard assets that want to go higher.
I'll tell you what, you hit on a key point. The demand figures in last Friday's report showed very high demand for wheat, very high demand for corn, very high demand for soybeans, record in some cases. So demand is not abating, no matter what the economic turmoil. We keep saying this, and it's true. People will not stop eating. They will not stop feeding their animals. They will not stop using the fuel that is, you know, ethanol-based and soybean oil-based. And so we really have a very steady and, in fact, growing demand for grains. It may be growing slowly, say 1% a year or so,
sure,
but it's growing. And even with economic uncertainty, when you see grains down here on their cyclical lows, when you've got a seasonal in place that seems to actually be kicking in, where your harvest seasonal, all that supply comes to market in 8, 10, 12 weeks, there's some potential opportunity here for investors.
You know, when we talk season, so I know that they go out, they get all the stuff off the ground, they put it in storage. That just totally makes sense that's where a low would come in. I mean, it's a supply and demand deal, right? You know,
It is. And in fact, I think if people read that seasonal study, they'll see that in the last 26 years, if you look at the December corn futures contract for next year, which happens to be what our ETF holds as well.
Yes.
Because an investor's in it for the longer haul. You're not in it just for a week or two. You're in it to buy and buy the down cycle. And so if you're owning out the curve, if you look a year out during harvest season, 46% of the lows in the last 26 years have come in between September and December. And in fact, December has the most with 6 of 26 lows. And I think, again, to your point, farmers come into the fields now, they're harvesting, and most of them are putting it in storage. They're putting what they can harvest into storage, waiting for that late spring rebound that often occurs. And what happens is their bins will get full. So at the very end of the harvest season, down towards November-ish, they run out of room and they have to sell. And I'm convinced that that's what results in that sometimes December seasonal low versus the October 1st low, which is really strong seasonal in corn.
Man, I would have loved being a kid running around in a couple of those farms and see where those bins are getting filled, man. Right?
Yeah, it's good fun. It's good fun. I worked for Cargill and was out at, you know, buying corn at grain elevators in Iowa for a bit. It's an interesting thing. It really is.
Well, because, you know, when you're understanding the actual physical like that, that you're out in those fields and you're realizing, hey, these things are getting filled. I mean, we see it as a digital deal, and it's great that you have a study like this that we can look at. But I know when you have a hands-on type of deal, it's like, hey, where's it going to go? It can't go outside because it gets ruined, right?
I think that's why I'm so amazed that more people don't pay attention to the seasonals, especially in eggs.
Right. I can definitely see that. You know, there's plenty of people that we talked about the different ETFs that you have, corn, soybeans, cane, and wheat. Now, the tags fund, you have all four of those in one fund, right?
We do. It's the old Deutsche Bank fund, the DBA, which now is a broad basket. It's a very good broad basket agricultural exposure fund. Not my fund. I don't get anything for plugging it. But I found that it was people needed to get direct exposure to the big four, what we call the big four, corn, soybeans, wheat, and sugar.
Yes.
And given that corn and soybeans compete for land, wheat is wheat. It's basically grown the same time and most of the same places that corn and soybeans are. And sugar, you know, sugar is a big agricultural commodity that does have some pretty good seasonality to it. Sugar is an interesting market right now. We are 5 years into a bear market because there's been more supply, more sugar grown in the world in the past 5 years than it was demanded. And this year, it's flipping. There's going to be more demand than supply.
And it's moving higher, there's no doubt. Well, listen, we really appreciate the update. We look forward to having you on again. And, you know, welcome to the bull market, man.
Pleasure, as always, Tom.
Okay, man, have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD.
For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down 57. You get the Nasdaq off 42. S&Ps are down 16. They're whacking this baby coming into the close. And if we do go over and we take a look at how they had tested the highs out here today, folks, it's pretty cool. So if you bring this back, what you're going to see, when we were on this morning show, the market, the S&Ps, the minis, went from 97 up, tested the spike highs that were up here from the 12th, and couldn't hold. They didn't hold the 10-minute. That's a big number, folks. They just couldn't. You had the spike. The spike was taking out the stops. Bottom line, gave it up in spades. Can't bust them up. Guess what? You're going to go bust them down. We take a look at the NQs, same setup in the NQs. And what had happened is this. If you were listening this morning, it was the S&Ps that were given the signal. What had happened is that when the NQs were spiking, the S&P couldn't handle it. And, you know, if you trade either one of those vehicles, folks, keep both of them up, because not all the time, but most of the time, one will not confirm the other. And when the S&P, what I've found is this, when the S&P doesn't confirm it, I really love it, you know, because what ends up happening is that it just seems to click much better. And what ends up happening is that if you're trading ranges, zones going back and forth, when the type of trading that we've been in here is pretty cool, because the ranges that you're in, the S&P seems to give you a more steady signal, and then you can fade the NASDAQ. That's how this thing shakes out. Where are we at here? Man, this is 15 minutes. This is going to be one of these turn the machines off, man. This is going to be interesting watching this thing shake out, because this S&P still wants lower price. So, and what this is saying that inside of the good Wall Street machine, I would say that someone already has the J.P. Morgan numbers, because J.P. Morgan is going to come out. J.P. Morgan is going to affect this market after the close, man, because that's the largest, one of the best run banks out there. And if that baby can't push up some big numbers, that's a big number in itself. So right now you get the S&Ps at 94, and 86 is game. You know, 86 is game. 86 is the low that was generated out here at 1400 hours on the 8th. That's the way that is set up at this particular point. Inside the, let me see if this IBB is getting some juice. Yeah, it is. The IBB is down 956 right now. This is going to be dangerous for the IBB. The lows on the IBB at 285, 292, or 299 right now. REGN. Let's see what this psycho stock is doing. Yeah, Regeneron's down $18.38. It was up yesterday. It was up $25. It closed up 20. Right now, you're coming right back down. It's just absolutely amazing. There's no doubt. Now, let's go over to J.P. Morgan. Take a look at J.P. Morgan. So J.P. Morgan can't handle higher price, you know, and that's saying 6086. It doesn't have to get killed. But 5973, 6086. Let me put this on a. Maybe it's going to be Intel that's going to whack this mark. Well, no, actually, you know what? No, it's going to get killed. So J.P. Morgan, you have all these high volume swing lows. We get the high volume swing low from the 24th of August, $50. It's probably a bad trade, but $50. The ones that are good trades are $54 though. It's been pushing lows with $54. So this could set up a real trip on the S&Ps as we're coming into these lows out here. Intel's gonna be the other big one, of course, after the close. Intel's also set up to back down. You know, Intel just made a run from $27 up to $32. That's coming into the downdraft out there from the 26th. You know, it's not that Intel is going to get croaked either, but $29.42 is on the agenda. Put this on a monthly. Yeah, on a monthly, this is gonna be a tough one actually, because if Intel doesn't get back inside $29, that's saying Intel can get up into a higher price point. Intel's a toss up. Yeah, Intel's definitely a toss up. Some of the Dow stocks out here. Let's take a look at some of the Dow stocks. You have Big Blue down $1.60. Honeywell's off $1.66. Walmart's down $23. United Tech's off $1.30. 3M's down $1. Let's see if we have anything that's positive inside the Dow. Yeah, you're positive inside the Dow. United Health is up 143. Goldman's up 98. Disney's up 29. And DuPont's up 10. Taken away from it is Merck down 130. United Technologies 131. Pfizer and Big Blue 155. Inside the NDX, what we have... you have Baidu is the leader out there. Tesla is number 2. Autodesk is 3. And this INCY, you talk about a stock that is going to just, this is a biotech too, but this is like a psycho stock, man. This is like crazy. So check this out. This stock was at $133 September 18th. On the 28th, it was at 89. 3 days later, it was at 131 again. 5 days later, it's at 99. And now it's on its way to go break. Well, you're at 101, but it looks like it's gonna go break 89.23. Oh yeah, it's a mess, man. This is like crazy. Okay, so you have a high volume spike low at 89.23, but there's two of them. This thing's on its way down to like $75. Man, there's going to be some nasty downdrafts out here, folks. I mean, big time, too. And, you know, what you're going to have today, so watch what you're actually going to have. You're going to have a market that went higher, failed, because right now in the NYSE, we only have 595 million. We did 716 million yesterday. That's saying we're going to come up about 800 million. So you get a failure on price and volume. And on the NASDAQ, you're going to come in with about 1.7 billion. That also is a failure on price and volume. This is like a classic too. I mean a classic. The composite got to 4858, which is over all the highs. You get a close. We're at 4795 right now. We'll see how much further we go down into the close out here. We go take a look at the SPY, what you're gonna see. Same setup. The SPY, we got to a price point out here of 202.16. You're at 200.16 right now. Just giving it all up. And what you have, well, let's go look at the IWM. And what you have, by the way, with all of these is that they went into those highs. They have lighter volume. They gave it up in price, gave it up in volume. That sets up the leg down. Now, what's so cool, man, is that it's option expiration on Friday. And that being said, don't forget our man, Mr. Dave White, is going to have a great workshop tomorrow afternoon, folks, okay? If you're a subscriber to his daily newsletter, you can come in the workshop, but you can subscribe 30 days absolutely free. Get over there and do it. Dave's really good at options. particularly good at option expiration. You know, risk versus reward, it's where it's at. It's right on the front page of TFNN. Dow Industrials right now are down 50, Nasdaq's up 41, S&P's are down 15 and a half. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down 57. You get the Nasdaq off 43. S&Ps are down 16 and a half. And they're pressing this into the lows out here. If we take a look at these E-minis just for a second, what you have is that we are down 17. Yep, you're going to get this. So watch, there's nothing in between here, folks, to 1988. You know, we hit the top of it. See, the top of this bar was from 1,400 hours on the 8th. That's 1994. You're into it, and you're into it right now at expansion of volume. So we'll see. If you get a couple points into that, you'll get to the 1988. And you're at 94 to 95 right now. Inside the NQs. Let's see where this level is inside the NQs. The NQs, we are at 42. The top of that level. Ooh, the top of that level is a lot lower. Not even close. The NQs don't have much at all. So the last time that the NQs had any juice on the way up, this is pretty wild, it's 43.07. The NQs, so in that context, you can see that the S&Ps have more of a advantage right now than the, more support than the NQs. That's about as wild as you get, though. There's no doubt about that, man. That's pretty intense. Dow out here, let's see what we got. There he is. So the Dow is down 48. That's no big deal inside the Dow. Let's go see if we get any indication of what's happening with JP Morgan Chase. It's not a sell-off, but yet it's at its lows. Intel, INTC. Now, what will happen with Intel likes coming out right after the close, and so does JP Morgan Chase. So we are going to see some action right after the close. And, JP Morgan was prepping the market this morning, saying that they're getting rid of all their Blackberries. They're not going to have allow some of their employees to have cell phones, period. And by the way, JP Morgan Chase, folks, okay, they have 237,000 employees. So you are talking about huge amounts of Blackberries out there that are no longer going to be getting subscription models off them. So that's going to be pretty intense just in itself. But I suspect what that's about is that, so you can cut expenses and make your bottom number. What the market, I suspect, is going to be looking at is that they're going to be looking at the top number, revenue. So what happens is that the revenue more than likely is going to come in light. If the revenue comes in light, they're going to hit these banks, because the wild card here inside raising rates has to do with the Fed protecting banks. The quickest way for the banks to go to higher price would be for the Fed to raise rates. So then the spread goes up, and fundamentally, they should be making more money. That's how that shakes out. My take right now is that the market's not going to let them raise rates. Why? Just because of pullbacks like this and the way that the bond is operating. When you put that together, then you put together about what the rates are overseas. It's like, we're at 2%. So when you go through this at 2%, Brazil is a mess. That's at 5.7. Colombia's at 4. Mexico's at 3.5. Other than that, you're talking about Switzerland is minus 0.2%. Sweden is 0.6. Italy is 1.6. Bottom line, you get the gist of it. We have high rates right now. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back with some good numbers for you. Dow right now is down 50. Nasdaq's off 42. S&P's are down 15. We have gold up 310. Gold wants higher price, baby. 1167. Silver wants higher price. 1588. We're going to be right back, folks.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Sam in Irvine, California. Hey, Sam, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great. You having a good day out there?
I am having a great day. Thank you very much. I want to preface by saying that I'm so grateful to you and TFNN for you to assemble such a great people, such a team to help the small investors like myself.
Well, we appreciate you growling and prowling out here with us, Sam. Thank you so much.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. The point of living is to believe the best is yet to come. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow finished down 49, Nasdaq off 42, S&P's down 14. Now, that doesn't seem that bad, folks, but each and every one of them failed at highs on price, on volume, couldn't handle price or volume. Gold up 290, traded at 1167. You got silver up 2 cents at 1588. Both gold and silver folks want higher price. They want to go after their May 18th swing high, which is dramatically higher from where we are right now. Platinum. Platinum down $6 at $9.89. You get copper down 3 pennies at $2.38 a pound. Light sweet crude down 53 cents, $46.58 a barrel. Bond oil looks like it's going back to the other side of its trend. That very well could be a buy there. The XLE is setting up real nice for a buy. Bonds, the 10-year up 5 ticks, 128.30. 30-year up 8 ticks, 158.02. The bond market, folks, once again has rejected lower price, wants higher price. The 10-year is still in an ABC structure on the way up at a 131 price level. King dollar. King dollar just can't handle higher price. King dollar up 10 ticks, 94.77. King dollar wants the lows of the 24th, which is in the 92.50 area. We'll see how it handles that area. You break that area in King dollar, and that's 85 in King dollar. That would be pretty intense. Euro. Euro is up 27, trading at 113, and you got the yen trading at 119.75. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? This is how it's set up, folks. Bottom line, S&P has tried to get to higher price. You did a nice counter trend bounce. You got up to the last bounce of the 17th of September. The high of there was 202.89. The low, 199.89. You did 276 million shares. Bottom line, last Thursday, we did 153 million. You got to 201.55. Friday, 107 million. Yesterday, 56. It's amazing that it can only do 82 million today, folks. This S&P wants to run back down to 186.93, which is the low that was generated out here on the 29th of September. We'll see what happens when we get down there. Bottom line, that's where I suspect we're going. NDX 100, the three Qs. What do we have? Same type of setup in the NDX 100. Hasn't been able to hold price, nor volume. What you have with the NDX 100, we're going into the same day, the 17th of September. The high of that day is 108.72. The low is 106.64. We've closed at 106.10. We did volume today of 26 million. You're dealing with 56 million. It's pretty intense, actually. Now, if we go to Intel, Intel just came out with numbers. So check this out. This is pretty cool, folks. Intel, bottom line, come out with numbers, decent numbers. Intel spikes higher. And guess what? Can't handle price. Pretty amazing. And this is after the close, by the way. Bottom line is that you had Intel close at 32.04. We traded up to 32.94. Now you're at 31.99. That is not going to handle higher price. And so what does that set up? Well, even without Intel, the Qs were dealing with lower price. But that is another confirmation that this market can't handle higher price. Now, what will happen is this. Intel itself is a large weighting structure inside the QQQ. The QQQs closed at 106.10. Bottom line, I suspect they're going to be off a few pennies. Yeah, the NQs right now at 43.41. The NQs had spiked. That's the NASDAQ futures. So they had spiked to 42.49, 42.50. Now they're going to close at the lower end of that range. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Bottom line, folks, they can't handle pushing gold. Well, gold can't handle lower price. Each and every time they try to push it down, it says, see ya, don't want to be ya. And gold has set up a really sweet potential ABC structure up. And it's a beauty, too, by the way. This structure, you know, we are at 1167. You have volume behind the push. First, we're already taking the swing point out of 1156.40. You're going after the swing point of 1169.80. I suspect we're going to get it, and that thing wants to go up to 1234. What has happened inside the XAU and the HUI, it's taken it out with volume, with price spread, all of the above. And in fact, there's a couple of these equities that are almost up to that May level right now. Bonds. Now, the bond market, as I've said many times, continues to give the most stable information in the marketplace. And it's just amazing. They cannot whack this bond market down. Bonds want higher price. And we're at 128.30. Bonds on October 2nd had taken out the swing point from the 24th and had taken out with volume, big volume too, by the way. You're talking about 1.9 million contracts. So you're at 128.30. You know, the bottom of that B bar is 128.05. So you have that ABC structure in place. I suspect we're going to get to 131. The 10-year right now, probably, it's right at 2.042. What I expect you're going to see out here tomorrow will continue lower tomorrow. You'll see that bond market continue higher, and more than likely, we very well may get the 10-year to complete that ABC structure on the way up. King dollar, bottom line, king dollar can't handle higher price. We have a king dollar. She's inside the trading range of the 24th. The high of that range is 95.27. We're at 94.79. And I suspect we'll build up some cause to get down into that lower level. Now, if we take a look at the continuous contract in King Dollar, this is where the, you know, if you were a bull in King Dollar, this would be very dangerous. If you're a bear in King Dollar, you kind of dig it. And what it is this. When you take a look at King Dollar and you put this up on a longer term basis, when we went up in 2014, folks, okay, you went straight up. July 2014, King Dollar's at 79. It was a straight line move up to 100. The consolidation, the bottom of this consolidation is the 94.95. You break that level, and both times we'll be down there with volume. So on a technical basis, it's saying that the force is downtown. You break that, you can be down at 85 in a heartbeat. I mean, at a heartbeat. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming back. Let's see if JP Morgan came out yet with numbers. JP Morgan's going to be coming out after the close. They haven't come out yet. I think JP Morgan's scared of coming out with numbers. They're supposed to come out in the morning. They changed that. They didn't want to come out in the morning. They said another bank's going to come out in the morning. They say they're going to come out in the afternoon. Bottom line is that they're going to wait for an hour or two so people can't sell them.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls.
Now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. J.P. Morgan just came out with numbers. So J.P. Morgan closed at 61.55. You're trading at 60.97 right now. And let's see what they say. Oh, my God. Okay, so we're going to go through a bunch of these. And net revenue is $1.6 billion. Well, that's the mortgage revenue. The the legal reserve, this is interesting. They had to take, well, this is what they did. They allowed... When you put money in for legal reserves, bottom line, they took it back out to put it into benefits. The bottom line is that they're trading this baby down. I expect you're going to see it a lot lower. Now, folks, let's go over to our man, Mr. Andy Hecht. And don't forget, Andy has an outstanding show every Tuesday and Thursday, 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time, right after my show. Get that show right on your cell phone, tfnn.mobi. Andy also has a great newsletter, Technomental Commodity Report. You can test drive that 30 days, absolutely free, the way you do it. Come over to our website at TFNN, go to newsletters, go to trading newsletters, you see the Technomental Commodity Report. You can test drive it right here, right now. Andy Hecht, welcome back, man.
Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing great. Yourself?
I'm doing great.
Cool, man.
Doing great.
Cool.
Nice vacation.
That's,
I actually got to meet Steve Rhodes.
Yeah, that's awesome,
which was,
man.
Which was really nice.
Totally.
Yeah. You guys really good time.
Grooving good. Out in the east coast of Florida.
That's right. Delray Beach.
Delray Beach. I know that beach well.
Nice. It was nice. Lots of fun. Lots of fun. So, and you're off to Vegas.
We are off to Vegas in the morning. Yes, we are.
That's right. So I will see you here.
You sure will, man.
It's a good thing you're coming tomorrow and not today, because today there's a circus going on.
A real circus?
Well, there's the Democratic debate is right on the Strip.
Oh, okay. Oh, man, I'm glad we're there tomorrow. Yeah.
No, they'll all be cleared out.
There's always tonight. A circus in Vegas.
Well, that's for sure. That's for sure. It's a new circus that comes into town tomorrow with the Traders Expo, right?
Totally.
Yeah. So markets are interesting. It looks precious metals very impressive. Feels like the path of least resistance is higher here.
Yeah.
You know, I got to get over this 1170. It seems like it's going to do it pretty easily.
It's, you know, listen, the equities are up 40-45% in 2 weeks. So, you know, to me, they're going. I mean, there's a couple equities that are almost up to the May 18th level right now. So,
yeah. You know, let me put a crude oil chart up here. I'm not liking the action there. And it's basically because of what I'm seeing in processing spreads. The gasoline crack spread is down to about 860.
Okay.
So that's the lowest level in a year. But the heating oil, you know, we're coming into the winter season.
Yep.
And the heating oil crack should be showing some strength. Instead, it is at the lowest level since January 2011. And that's telling me that demand for products is not that good. That's, you know, the heating oil is not just heating oil, it's diesel too.
Sure, for the jets. Yeah, right.
Well, to bring goods to market.
Right.
So it's a bit of a problem here.
And you have Ryder, you know, it's interesting too with that Ryder, the big trucking firm. The big trucking firm out here got smoked today, Andy. You know?
That truck traffic, great. and the heating oil contracts reflecting that the products are weak. So I think we're going to pull back maybe to $43 or something on crude oil. Then we'll see how it looks down there. I mean, I don't think it's heading back to $38. We have a lot of things on the horizon. You know, in November, we're going to have the biannual meeting of OPEC, which should be very interesting. So, you know, while precious metals are looking good and commodities have bounced nicely since the end of the third quarter.
I apologize, folks. So we have some problems here. We'll find out what it is.
Do you hear me?
Just give us a second, Andy. Okay, let me run through this. They'll figure this thing out. Well, Andy and I, we were talking about the oil market, folks, and we're going to get Andy right back. Bottom line is that there's no doubt in this oil market right now we're at 46.61, and you know the lower end of this is 43.99. And yeah, how we back into that is going to be, you know, if we back in, I would love to see this thing really try to get into like 41.22 at light volume. The reason, folks, is that the XLE, you know, the XLE came off the lows, came off them with some good strength. It's pulling back today. We're, you know, the XLE is down 72 right now. We're at 67.33. And you can kind of watch this thing come back into 62.58. If you come back into the 62.58 area and you have lighter volume, that would set up a nice buy. Let's go back over to JP Morgan for a second and take a look where they're trading. So they're trading down 55, which is not the end of the world. And numbers go like this. Let's see if we can break these out. Yeah, it takes more than just a couple one-liners for the return on tangible equity is 15%. They're going to take a credit for credit for tax losses, for credit losses rather, $682 million. The compensation expense 7.2. Okay, so they're claiming that they're in. Profit increased 22% on tax benefits. So we'll see where that shakes out. Let's go over to SanDisk, SNDK. SanDisk closed, SNDK. So SanDisk closed at $61.77. That's trading up $8 right now. It's $69.44. That has some juice underneath it. Let's see what they're saying. Oh, look at this. They're working. They'll pull anything out. You have to love it. So they're working with a banker to explore a sale. Said to be worth working with the banker to explore a sale. If we take a look at SanDisk, let's see where that has been. Yeah, so SanDisk has been on a straight line down $108.77 in July, down to 44. Right now, you're at 61. We take a look at Intel. Intel was the biggest number out here today. Intel right now is, it closed at $32.04. It's traded up to $32.90. It's trading right now at $32.20. And Intel, the world's biggest chip maker, is forecasting fourth quarter sales that may exceed analyst expectations. Fourth quarter revenue will be $14.8 billion, plus or minus $500 million. The company said that was in line with analyst estimates of $14.8 billion. So check this out, folks. You're going to love financial writers. The first paragraph says, Intel, the world's biggest chip maker, forecasts fourth quarter sales that may exceed analyst predictions. Then the next quarter says it's in line. Bottom line is that you can see the gist of it. It's almost like they can't write a story with some facts in it at certain points. Right now, Intel at the 35 level, bottom line is that it doesn't have enough juice to bust through the 26th of June area. That 26th of June area is a troubled area. You stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming right back with our man, Mr. Andy Heck. We do apologize, sir, for that snafu. The Dow right now is down 49. Nasdaq's up 42. S&P's down 17. You have gold up 340. Silver's up 3. Bonds, the 10 years up 6. The 30 years up 9. We're going to be right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has just announced a brand new morning lineup that is geared specifically for traders in this volatile traders market. Every morning at 8 a.m., John Logan starts things off with his daily program, The Global Market Pulse. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento trades the market during the market open Monday through Friday on Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom O'Brien hosts the Money Masters for the hour, and Basil Chapman hosts his Tiger Technician's Hour at 11 a.m. From 8 a.m. till noon every market day, these traders are with you as they provide up-to-the-second market information so that you can make the most educated and profitable trades possible. The new TFNN morning lineup is happening right now. Tune in to see for yourself what kind of actionable trading discussion they have each morning, Monday through Friday, starting at 8 a.m., live only on Tiger TV at TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go back to our man, Mr. Andy Hecht. And don't forget, folks, Andy's got a great show right here at TFNN. 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time every Tuesday, Thursday. Get it right on your cell phone, TFNN.MOBI. Sorry about that, brother.
That's okay. That's okay. I'm glad it's not on my end. It usually is. Anyway, weather here in Vegas is beautiful, so you should be arriving.
Nice. So what is that? Is it 80, 75? What is
yeah,
that?
Yeah, it's like 80, 85 degrees.
Cool, man. Cool.
Really nice.
And folks, we're going to be at the Paris Hotel, the Traders Expo at the Paris Hotel. We get a booth there. We'll be there Wednesday night. It opens Wednesday night. We'll be there all Thursday, Friday. TD Ameritrade, man, JJ is going to be there. Kevin Hinks is going to be there. We're all going to, Andy's going to be there. Larry Pesavento is going to be there. My son Tommy's going to be there. So come on out and visit us if you happen to be in that area.
Should be lots of fun.
Yeah, totally, man.
No question. So, you know, very interesting. While I was away, you know, a lot certain markets were really kind of picked up. You know, the rice market exploded.
I'm a wicked bull now, Andy. Since you left, those softs. The softs
look great. I mean, sugar gave something back today.
It did, but it should have.
Coffee.
Yeah.
I'm liking coffee here. I mean, I have a sugar chart up here. You could see how that has moved up 25%, you know, in the last 2 weeks.
It's amazing.
Yeah, amazing. Coffee also looking good. I think what happened is, let me put up a chart of rice, because we never really talk about rice. And the price of rice just exploded. It's come off a little bit here, but, you know, back since May, prices just exploded higher. And that was because of El Nino. So now these kind of fears are translating to these very low price soft commodities.
Okay.
I'm particularly loving coffee here. I think sugar looks really good. That's up like 25%.
It is.
Looking really interesting.
And wheat, you know, corn, soybeans, they're all come off the lows with nice volume, man.
Absolutely. And I was listening to Sal in the first hour.
Yeah.
And he's right. You know, we make cyclical lows this time of the year. These are all very interesting markets now. And the whole commodity complex has popped here. And I think one of the interesting things, you saw that Fortress, the macro hedge fund, basically shutting down. They were down 17.2%.
Right.
You know, that could be a signal that maybe there's some, you know, maybe this is kind of the lows for now for commodities.
Well, but it's been happening a lot. I mean, Glencore is still in trouble, you know?
Right.
I mean, you know,
right.
I thought that one of the amazing things about Glencore, you know, they were basically saying that, no, we have plenty of trading money and this and that. But the fact of the matter is, man, they're still selling mines. They're selling everything they can get there, you know, they can push out. And they everything they sell, they're claiming they don't need. It's like, okay, man.
Right. Well, what you're going to see is production cuts. I'm keeping my eyes on copper and oil. That's going to tell us. Look, China is certainly the 800-pound gorilla in terms of commodities. And I still think we're in for volatile times. I think these markets will vacuum down and vacuum up, but we're nicely off the lows here. And, you know, the last 2 weeks, we had the worst quarter of the year in a long time, actually, in the third quarter for all raw material prices. But we've bounced nicely, you know, and it seems that precious metals are leading the way. Platinum's still lagging. It's still below $1,000. But that platinum gold spread has moved from $230 discount up to about $177 discount. So we're seeing some good signals here. We'll have to wait and see. As I was saying in the first segment, I am a bit concerned about oil, which I think can back off here to the high 40s. You know, 42, 43 bucks.
Yeah, no, I'd like to see it. I agree. I mean, you know, I would love to see, I mean, you know, oil took off from what? The 42, 41. It'd be really nice to see a pullback there with light volume and then take off again. Because if it did, that's telling me that, see, where my head's now, Andy, and it had to do with first the gold and silver equities were moving really counter trend to the S&P. And now they're up. Most of them are up 40%. Okay, so it's like, okay, that's real, right?
Mm-hmm.
But then when I saw the soybeans go and the wheat go and the corn go, I'm saying to myself, oh man, we haven't seen something like this, and you know, since 2002. But that would make sense to me because they got killed, you know. So
right, we have to remember they're coming from very, very low levels.
I know that, but that's what happens with commodities, right? I mean,
exactly.
to the moon, then you go to hell.
Yeah. Exactly. I mean, even cotton took off today. You know what's this is just, it's the same thing we've been saying all years. This is a great year for traders. It's a trader's paradise. This thing is markets are bouncing all over the place. And, you know, I think that'll probably continue in the fourth quarter. It'll be a rocky road. I don't think we're going to see a moonshot in commodities straight up. There's too many things with China that would prevent that.
Yeah. You know what I loved? You know, today, folks, the Wall Street Journal had a story again on Andy Hall.
Right.
And they were lining everyone up against him. And I love seeing that, folks, if you don't know it, you know, Andy happens to know Andy Hall. But Andy Hall is probably one of the, I don't know if he's the best oil trader, but definitely someone that has made money hand over fist. And it's so cool watching the article as they're lining everyone up against them that probably never did an oil trade but just accumulates money and trades, you know, like says, oh, give me your money, I know what's going on, versus someone that has money in the game. Do you know what I mean?
Right. Look, Andy Hall is a survivor. He's gone through many difficult periods. This is you have huge ranges in the oil market and huge moves this year. You know, he's bullish on oil and he's suffered the last couple of months. We'll see how it pans out for him.
Right, because and what the article was about is, you know, how the trade set up. The trade set up as, well, they think the trade set up, as you said, longer ranging versus shorter ranging. That's because that's his MO, right?
Yeah. Right. The only thing I would say about Andy Hall is he's into his 60s now. He's got plenty of money. You know, if it gets too aggravating, it is possible that he'll retire.
Yeah, no.
I could see
but
that.
But I saw the picture of him. He ain't retiring. He's in amazing shape. He's not retiring.
I think he was the captain of the rowing team at Cambridge or Oxford.
Okay, yeah.
He continues to row. But hey, listen, he doesn't work for the money. He works for the thrill of the game.
Yeah, right. Right.
So he's not going
to pack it in. Right.
We'll see. Chances are he's not going to pack it in. But chances are in the long run, he's going to get this right.
Yeah, I agree. There's no doubt.
But Fortress, I think that could be a signal, you know, when these Glencore, Fortress, all these kinds of things. But what it all means to me, especially with the Glencore, is you're going to see production cuts. And that's what these markets really need.
Yes.
They really need production cuts.
There's no doubt.
If you get production cuts, you're going to get higher prices. That's just classic economics.
Well, I thought it was intriguing one of his only quotes, this is Andy Hall's, folks, one of his only quotes were that we're all going to get used to lower energy prices and just keep going and doing more things. And sure, that's what you do.
Right.
And so then you get, more demand going and you get, that makes sense.
Right. And that's exactly right. But that's what's bothering me about oil now, because what I'm seeing in the product is a little scary for the oil price.
Yeah.
The fact that heating oil cracks traded down to 1438 today. I mean, that's since 2011. Let me see if I could get a chart up of that. I want to show you that, because that's kind of key. Let's just put up a monthly chart. It might take a second to get it up there.
Yeah, and if I look at VLO, okay, which is affected, that just double topped. So that, it's trading 62. That can go back to 42 in a heartbeat. Yeah,
exactly. Right. And remember, VLO did really well while oil was coming down, because the crack spread
was huge. VLO just went from let me see this thing. Yeah, we went from 43. Yeah, 43 to 70.
Yeah, amazing move. Huh?
Well, cooking, brother. Listen, man.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Back. See me tomorrow, but I'm going to hear you in another 25 minutes.
Absolutely.
Take it, man.
Okay, bye.
Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. Dow finished down 49. NASDAQ 42. S&P's down 18. We're going to be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. So J.P. Morgan, they closed at 61.55. It's trading down, no big deal, 60 cents at 60.90. What they did is that, they supposedly were cleaning up their legal costs, but bottom line is that they evidently have something else coming down the pike because they had to load up, they had to take 26 cents off their third quarter and push a huge amount of money into their legal fund. The consumer revenue fell 4%. Corporate investment banking revenue fell 10%. So when you cut to the chase of what they made versus what the estimate was, $1.38. They came in with $1.29. And so we'll see where, in fact, how much climb, but. Compensation. Where's that legal expense? It's amazing the amount of money that they put in legal. It is what it is. And all those banks keep doing is, bottom line is that making legal expense part of their overhead. And it's pretty amazing just watching that whole thing shake out. What we will see, no doubt, tonight is these overseas markets are going to get some action. Well, here, talk about overseas. Let's go. I want to go to Shanghai for a second because, Andy and I were talking commodities. Shanghai, folks, came off the lows two nights ago with some real juice. This is going to be wild watching this thing shake out. So Shanghai is at 32.93. Now, if we dissect this on a much larger basis here. So Shanghai, from 2014, this is amazing what it's done actually. So check this out. If we start, never mind 2014, let's start, we're still in 2015, can I do that? Yeah, I can. So watch how crazy this is. And January, okay. So January 2015, we're in October right now. January 2015, Shanghai was at 3,126, 3,126. It went sideways for about 8 weeks. And then in March, it took off like a rocket ship. It went from 3,198, and it never stopped till it got to 5,178. So that high was in June 12th to be exact. So check this out, March, April, May, June. That's crazy. Okay, so it was 90 days. 90 days, you went from 3,100 to 5,100. So what's that? It's 2,000, it's almost, that's like 70%, right? Now, from that point on, it only took 4 weeks to get back to 3,300. The high was established in June. By August 28th, so we went from June 19th to August 28th, we go back to 2850. It only took 2 months to get back down. So it was 3 months up, 2 months down. Now, so that's 100% move of a move. My take is that we're going to go to 2,500 and we got to what, 2,850. Okay, so now let's get in closer and see what we have here. So what we did when Shanghai reopened, folks, okay, there was a lot of bent up demand, but the bottom line is that you got volume in the exchange. It was the first time we got volume in a long time. And what Shanghai had already done, it had already tested its lows with lighter volume. It just got keep getting whacked. One of the main reasons, of course, is that they don't let what Shanghai did is that they stopped trading about 40 to 50% of their stocks. You can't sell stock if you own more than 5% in it, all of the above. Okay, that being said and done, Shanghai came in two nights ago at 38 billion shares. Now, that's saying that you're going to get a real bounce here. So if we put this back on a weekly, 33. So here's the number. 3373 is something that we're going to really watch real closely. This is why. 3373 was the last time that Shanghai was down with big volume. If you can get into that number and we get into it with juice, that would be saying that, guess what? Shanghai, you know, is going to start making it into higher price. And the way that Shanghai trades, that could be very fast and furious. Now, where I'm going with that, I'm not going that, yeah, just because Shanghai is going up, everything's going to go up. Where I am going with that is right into the commodity business once again. Because see, if we go over and if I look at just about all these, you know, if I, hey, let's pull up copper. If you look at SCCO, that thing's been moving big time. SCCO is the largest copper stock in the world. Let me see. But let me get up the actual copper. Where is she? I know I must be going right out. There she is. Okay, so it was down 1.5% today. You come off the bottom. Yes, you come off this bottom with juice, man. Copper went straight down. We went straight down last 6 months from 294 down to 220. Yet you come off with volume September 8th. You got to 244. You pull back with dramatically lighter volume again. When we say dramatically light, you pull back with 38,000 contracts going into 100,000. And then last Thursday, it's pushing with volume again. Copper wants to break this level. Look, copper looks like it wants to go to 261. You get that going, HG1. We put this on a continuous contract. Put this on a monthly. And what you're going to see, 2011, we were at 464. You get down to, look at that. Yeah, was that 213? You get down to 220, and that was going into the strength from 2009. We're at 237. Once copper needs is this. Copper needs on a weekly basis, wide price spread, and volume. And if it gets that going into the 241 area, then that's going to build a case that copper can get up to 308. But see, 308 is still ice. That's all that is. That'd be a big bounce, but that on a technical aspect, I don't even think that's a 0.382. That's probably a 0.27. Well, 314 is a 0.382. ICE is set up at 343, and that's a 50% bounce. But if you don't get volume going with that simultaneously, all that means is that would be a dead cat bounce. But if you go over to SCCO and we take a look at SCCO, this is a decent setup. This is Southern Copper. And Southern Copper never got down into its lows when, in fact, the copper contract itself was. Southern Copper's been building cars. Now, it needs more volume, there's no doubt about that. But the lows that were established out here in 2008, the highs of the lows it didn't even get to. You know, it went to 23, the highs of those lows were 18. So, this is Tom O'Brien, this is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. Our man, Mr. Andy Heck, is going to be coming up at 5. We're going to be coming back for another 10 minutes. The Dow right now finished down 49, Nasdaq off 42, S&P's down 19 and a half. We're going to be right back, folks.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help
help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. And if we go over and we take a look at that XLF, what you're going to see inside the XLF, that couldn't handle price out here today. You're at 23.08. That's going to make its way down into this 22.12 area. We'll see whether you get a breakdown coming into that area. Let me see. I think J.P. Morgan, let's say we got here. Right. Whoops. Oh, this is interesting. Okay, hold on. Wells Fargo. I guess Wells Fargo might have come out this morning. You know, it's interesting. Wells Fargo said they were going to come out this morning, but all they actually did is that, I'm not sure. It doesn't look to me like they're out yet, but they did come across and said that they were buying GE assets, monster GE assets, $32 billion of GE assets. We go to Bank of America. Let's see when Bank of America is coming out. BAC is coming out. That's going to come out at 0700 tomorrow morning. So Bank of America right now, this one's going to be interesting, because Bank of America is hanging at its lows. The low that was established on the 24th was 1460. It came back down there and broke that low on October 2nd. Well, it went into it, 1463. Bank of America is going to, this Bank of America is going to get on a test drive, that baby, in WFC's tomorrow, man. Thanks, Terry. So that's pretty wild. So Wells Fargo, okay, 0800 tomorrow. Awesome. Thank you, man. That's going to be 0800 tomorrow. Now, Wells Fargo also is looking to me like, you're at 51.86, 49.51 is game. That October 2nd low inside of these swing points, inside of these consolidations, want to be tested inside that banking structure. SanDisk came out and said that they are looking to get sold. That's up $7, $61.77. And if we take a look at SanDisk, let's see what they're doing on a fundamental basis. Yeah, look at that. So this is smart of them, actually. So SanDisk on a fundamental basis, they had a nice acceleration. You know, 2011, they're doing $5.7 billion a year. 2012, 5.1, 2013, 6.2. Last year, 6.6. This year, 5.6. So they came down $1 billion this year. That's a big number, $250 million per quarter. You know, they want someone else to take the headaches right now. And as one of the tigers said in the den, it's really unusual when, let me get to the exact quote, because this exact quote is that SanDisk said to be working with bank to explore sale. When that happens, folks, they're looking to get sold. They don't have someone that's going after them. What they're looking, they're putting the bait in the water out there saying, hey, listen, you know, can you buy me? Can you buy me? If we go over to that gold contract once again. So what we have with gold, folks, is this. Gold, just in the last 2 weeks, has gone from 1103 to 1168. Now, what that's going to do is this. If we go into the GLD, what you're going to see, and this is where the aspect of ETFs help on the way up, but they're wicked on the way down. So what you have is that as gold goes to higher price, well, guess what? They have to turn around and buy more gold. Now, today, they didn't have to. Right now, the SPDR, the GLD, holds 687.20 metric tons of gold. That had gotten as low as, I think, 588. Bottom line, what you're going to see, though, as that gold goes higher, that's where the whole chicken and egg thing goes. Pretty cool. You stay right there, folks. I'm Mr. Andy Hecht's going to be coming up next, growling and prowling with you. Always remember, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Stay tuned. Andy's coming right up. Bam! Go get him, folks.